Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn an important part of the ratio analysis, which is called a dew-point formula. The dew-point formula for ROE, that's what we are supposed to discuss here. As you can see, the dew-point formula is basically the profit margins that you make into the total asset turnover into the leverage factor. I think things didn't go in your brain. No issues. We can solve this out. Close enough to 1920s, the DuPont Corporation, it was the DuPont Corporation that came up with this formula, and they named it as the DuPont ROE. The DuPont ROE formula. And this formula helps us to understand the ROE in detail. So the formula of the return on equity as per the DuPont Corporation, okay, is what we just learned over here, the profit margin, the total asset turnover, and the leverage factor. No issues. Let's understand this with the help of an example. Let's say there's this company called Sutra and Company, which has some following details. It has the net income for the year as 50,000, the revenue for the year as 3 lakh, the total assets under management, let's say, of the company is $9 lakh. The shareholders' equity is, let's say, $1,50,000. Now, using the DuPont formula, we will get some details, something like this. But before that, we need to copy down the formula so that we have some clear idea. So this is your formula: profit margin, asset turnover, and the leverage ratio. Right, so we'll start. The return on equity, that is your ROE, is equal to your profit margin, asset turnover, and leverage ratio, or the dew point ROE, right? Which can be also, this can be also written as your net income divided by the revenues, that's your sales, into revenues. The asset turnover is basically your revenue or sales divided by the total assets. And the next thing that we have is the leverage ratio. So the leverage ratio is basically your total assets divided by the shareholders' equity. So this is going to be your leverage ratio, and this is how the whole formula has been divided. So our dew point ROE will go something like this: the net income, that is 50,000, divided by the revenue, that is 30,000. So we got our first answer, that is the profit margin over here as 0.166. Then we'll divide the revenue, divide by our total assets, right? So 0.33. And the last, that is the leverage ratio, that is the total assets divide by the shareholders' equity, and we'll multiply all of this three so as to receive the ROE as our answer. So our answer is going to be, we'll be multiplying all these three components, so our answer is 33.3%. So the ROE dew point formula that we just analyzed is 33%, or 33.33, right? So if we directly find out the return on equity, we will get something like this. Our ROE, that's the direct formula. ROE is equal to your net income, because the rest gets cut out, I mean shareholders' equity. So our net income is going to be 50,000 divided by the shareholders' equity, 1,50,000. So our answer remains again the same, 33. Okay, so this is basically the DuPont formula. That's why the things are on the... we have to go on the expanded version, how exactly the formula got incorporated. Now we'll take a real life example of Colgate for DuPont ROE. Now this is the DuPont ROE for Colgate. In the DuPont formula example, we calculated the DuPont ROE for Colgate over here. The return on owner's equity, or the ROE, has been calculated right in front of us. This is the formula. And as for the DuPont, this is the answers. The answers absolutely remains the same as we have already discussed. But the three factors that are supposed to be taken is the profit margin, the asset turnover, and the financial leverage. Now over here, the net income is taken after the profit margin. For profit margin, the net income, this portion, is taken after the minority shareholders payment, and therefore the shareholders equity consists of only shareholder over here. It consists of only equity or the common shareholders of the Colgate, and not including the minority holders. Now in case of the asset turnover, has been declining over the past 7 to 8 years, 15, 145, 139, 140, 130, and it is reducing to 126. In addition to the Colgate's profit margin have also declined over the past couple of years, as you can see. However, the return on equity, that is the ROE, has not shown a declining trend, as you can see. 93, 90, and then after it has moved on to 108, 99.7, 126, and so on and so forth. So this is because of the equity multiplier. Now, what is this? The equity multiplier that we are talking about over here is basically your total assets divided by your total equity. This is your equity multiplier. And we note that the equity multiplier has shown a steady increase over the past 5 years. And it's currently standing at 30x. Now, let's go to the explanation part of the DuPont formula. Now, if we break down the formula, we'll be able to make sense how it exactly it works. See, the first component of the formula is the net profit margin. That's the first part. If you look at the formula of the profit margin, it would be something like this. The net income divided by your revenues. Right? The second component in the formula is the total asset turnover. If you look at the formula, the total asset turnover would be revenue or the sales divided by the total assets. And the third component, the third most component, is basically your equity multiplier. Which is, if we look into the formula of the leverage factor, we would get as the total assets divided by the shareholders' equity. So, now if we put these three components in the DuPont formula, determined, we'll get the return on equity this way. It's what we just discussed, ROE, the profit multiplier into the, this is what we will we'll get. The ROE margins, the asset turnover, and so on and so forth. Right? And so, or you can say the ROE divided by the net income divided by revenue. You can also write this as this way. Right? So, this is the way you can write. The magic of the particular formula is when we multiply this three, ultimately we get what as the net income divided by the shareholders' equity, right? However, if we look at each, we would be able to understand the total four ratios together. The first, we will get to know how, to know what the profitability of the company is. Second, we'll be able to understand how efficiently the company has been utilizing its assets. Third, how much company's leverage or how much leverage a company has been getting. And the fourth most important, we'll also understand the return on equity overall. So, in return on equity formula, we are not only including the common shares, we are also taking into account the preference shareholders or the preference shares, the dividend, if any, into account. The shareholders' equity basically means that we will the whole statement and the total figures at the end. The use of the formula is that DuPont formula helps us to save time and effort, and the simultaneously they would be able to understand how efficiently a company is utilizing its resources and how leveraged the company is. Second, the ROE definitely throws a light on the proportion between the net income and the shareholders' equity. So it does not allow us to understand how much the profitability a firm has and how the firm has been utilizing its assets. And the third most important, with the DuPont, you can calculate all you need to do is just look at it into the income statement and the balance sheet and the shareholders' equity statement.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.